Hi guys,
in this video we are going to cover a very important topic pertaining to the RBI notification on the non-banking financial companies or NBFCs. Now this is a very important topic for the RBI and SEBI grade A 2019 examinations, and in this particular video we are going to discuss how this particular new notification, it makes certain changes in this NBFC criteria and what are the general provisions pertaining to the NBFCs in the country. So this was a notification which was in news recently about harmonization of different categories of NBFCs. Now this is a very recent notification which was issued on 22nd February 2019, and as you can see that this one is addressed to all the NBFCs that there has been some harmonization in the different categories of NBFCs. So let's learn about the harmonization, as well as let's also talk about the basic conceptual framework with regard to the NBFCs. Now, over a period of time, there has been this evolution of NBFC sector in the country, and several categories of NBFCs they have come up with in the country, and all of these they are now intended to separate sectors. They are now focusing on a specific sector or asset class. So you would find an NBFC which is specifically catering the motor vehicles. You may find an NBFC which is specifically catering the housing loans. So these kinds of NBFCs, they have come up, and different sets of NBFCs, they have posed sort of a regulatory problem as well as a sort of confusion in the minds of the regulators as well as the people as well. So now the attempt has been made to harmonize some of the categories of NBFCs into fewer ones. So this has been decided that in order to provide NBFCs with greater operational flexibility, harmonization of different categories of NBFCs, it has to be done, and this has to be carried out based on the principle of regulation by activity rather than regulation by entity. So all the NBFCs which are into same set of activity, they are going to be clubbed together, be it they may be separate entities, but we are not going to see the entity, we are going to focus on the activity which they are performing. We are going to focus on the wider goal or the wider target here. So in this respect, it has been decided to merge the three categories of NBFCs. So for now, three categories of NBFCs have been merged. So the start has been made by merging three categories of NBFCs. Now we are going to learn about the categories of NBFCs which have been merged, but first let's also take a look at the conceptual framework concerning the NBFCs, because this is the core part from which a core question or a conceptual question may be asked in the examination, or a question may be framed which would combine the conceptual part as well as the current news part. So let's also cover this conceptual part. Now NBFC, that is non-banking financial company, this is a company which is registered under the Companies Act, and this is engaged in the business of providing loans and advances or acquisition of shares, stocks, bonds, debentures or securities which are issued by government or local authority or any other marketable securities of a like nature. Or they may also be engaged in leasing, hire purchase, insurance business, chit fund business, but does not include. So these are the activities which can be performed by the NBFCs. They may be engaged in these sorts of activities, but they would not be engaged in activity. And for this, there is this clarification that they would not include any institution whose principal business is that of agriculture, industrial activity, purchase or sale of any goods or providing any service, and sale, purchase, construction of immovable property. So this is basically the negative list. If an entity's principal business is falling in these category of list, like this is manufacturing or providing goods or sale of immovable property, then this would not be an NBFC. So this is about what is an NBFC and what is not an NBFC. Now NBFCs, they pretty much sound like banks and the non-banking financial companies. So the bank word is inherent to the NBFCs. So what makes NBFCs unique? What are the differences between the banks and the NBFCs? Now NBFCs, they are lending, they are making investments, and their activities are very much similar to that performed by the banks, but there are a few differences which are as follows. First and foremost, NBFCs cannot accept demand deposits. So NBFCs, they won't have the facility of a saving account or a current account. You cannot have demand deposits with a NBFC. Further, NBFC do not form part of the payment and settlement system and cannot issue checks drawn on itself. So they are not part of the payment and settlement system and they won't give you checkbooks. So if you are having an account in an NBFC, then you won't be given a checkbook, which is a part of the overall payment and settlement system. Further, there is this deposit insurance facility of Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation, and this is not available to the depositors of NBFCs, unlike in the case of banks. So banks, if people are putting their deposits in the banks, they have this insurance facility of this DICGC, but the depositors of NBFCs, they do not enjoy this deposit insurance facility. So these are the broad three differences which distinguish NBFC from the banks. Now let's talk about the registration part. Now the NBFCs, they have to get themselves registered with the RBI. Now this is as per the provisions of section 45 IA of the RBI Act 1934, which says that no NBFC can commence or carry on a business of a non-banking financial institution except with the registration with RBI. So it says that registration with the RBI is must for NBFC, but it says in terms of the powers which are given to the bank to obviate dual regulation, certain categories of NBFCs which are regulated by other regulators, they are exempted from the requirement of registration with the RBI. So it says that if you fall in that category of NBFC which is already being regulated by some other regulator, so we do not want that you should be a victim of double regulation or dual regulation. So those NBFCs, they would be exempted from getting registered with RBI. Now, what are those NBFCs which are already regulated, which are already under the regulation of some other regulator? So here is a list of those sorts of NBFCs. So these are exempted from the RBI registration. So what are these? First is housing finance companies which are regulated by the National Housing Bank. So they are already regulated by some other regulator. So that's why they are out of the RBI purview. Further, merchant banker, venture capital fund company, stock exchanges, stock brokers, sub brokers, they are regulated by Securities and Exchange Board of India or SEBI. So since these are being regulated by the SEBI, so that's why they are again out of the RBI purview. Further, insurance companies as are regulated by IRDA, that is Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority. So then again, to obviate dual regulation, they are exempted from RBI purview. Further, chit fund companies which are already regulated by the respective state governments. So in this particular case also, the RBI regulations, they are exempt. Further, nidhi companies which are regulated by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. So in this case also, this RBI regulation or RBI registration, this is exempted. So in the case of these categories of NBFCs, in order to obviate, that is in order to remove the need for double regulation or double registration, they are exempted from the RBI registration. Now when we talk about the NBFCs, they have to meet this 50-50 criteria of principal business. Now RBI has been this given the powers under the RBI Act to lay down the policy directions and exercise supervigilance over the NBFCs, and that NBFCs, they have to meet this 50-50 criteria of principal business. So what is this 50-50 criteria? So this means that NBFCs should carry on financial activity as a principal business. Now when an NBFC would be deemed to carry on a financial activity as principal business, this is when a company's financial assets constitute more than 50% of the total assets and income from the financial assets should constitute more than 50% of the gross income. So both your assets as well as income, they should be more than half of your total assets or total income in order to be classified as a financial activity, and that would come under the purview of the NBFC, and subsequently RBI would regulate these sorts of NBFCs. So RBI has defined it so as to ensure that only companies which are predominantly engaged in the financial activity, they get registered with it and are regulated and supervised with it. So if there is a company whose just 1% of the income is from the financial assets, that would not be required to be registered with the RBI. So RBI only wants to deal with those companies which have a substantial chunk of their assets or their income coming from the financial sort of business. Now, if there are companies which are engaged in agriculture, industrial activity, trading of goods, services, or purchase or construction of immovable property as their principal business, and are doing some financial business in a small way, they are not going to be regulated by the RBI. RBI is not going to spend time regulating those which have a very minute portion of their business coming from the financial activity. RBI would only regulate those NBFCs which are meeting this 50-50 principal business criteria. So this is again something which we must remember in the context of NBFCs. Now, there are different categories of NBFCs which are there. For example, there is this asset finance company, which is primarily concerned with financing of the assets. There is this investment company concerned with the investments part, and there is this loan company concerned with the loans part. Next is infrastructure finance company, which is concerned with financing of infrastructure projects. Then is systematically important core investment company. Then is infrastructure debt fund, then is non-banking finance company, microfinance institute, then is non-banking finance company factors, then is mortgage guarantee companies, and then there are non-banking financial companies, non-operative financial holding company. So there can be different sorts of NBFCs and they're all engaged in different sorts of activities. Further, there is also a category of systematically important NBFCs or systemically important NBFCs. And the NBFC's asset size is of rupees 500 crore or more as per the last audited balance sheet. They are considered as systemically important NBFC's because they have a very huge asset size. They will have a everlasting impact on the economy if they fail to do good. So that's why they are being classified as systemically important NBFC. The rationale for such classification is that the activity of these NBFCs, it is going to have a bearing on the financial stability of the overall economy. Now, for the purpose of understanding of this notification which we are covering, the following three types of NBFCs, they are going to be relevant for us. First is asset finance company. Now, this is a finance company which is primarily engaged in the principal business of financing of physical assets, such as automobile, tractors, generator sets, other material handling equipment, or moving on own power and general purpose industrial machines. Then is investment company, which is carrying on its principal business as the acquisition of securities or shares or bonds. Next is loan company, which is a company whose principal business is the providing of finance, whether by way of making loans or advances or otherwise for any activity other than its own. So these are the three categories of NBFCs which we are going to be relevant for us for this particular notification. Now there has been a merger of three categories of NBFCs which include asset finance company, loan company and the investment companies which we have just covered. So these three categories of NBFCs, they have been merged into a new category which is NBFC, investment and credit company. So all the differential regulations which are there with regard to the NBFCs in these three respective sectors, they are now going to be converged, they are now going to be harmonized as well. Further, a deposit taking NBFC ICC, it shall invest in unquoted shares of another company which is not its subsidiary company or which is not in the same group of NBFC, an amount not exceeding 20% of its owned fund. So this NBFC ICC shall not invest exceeding 20% of its own fund in the unquoted shares of another company. So this again stipulation has been provided. So primarily we have to remember that these three categories, they have been merged into one category now. Now in this regard, non-banking financial companies acceptance of public deposits Reserve Bank Directions 2016, they have been amended and a new definition of NBFC investment and credit company has been added. So it says that investment and credit company means a company which is a financial institution which is carrying on its principal business as asset finance. the providing of finance by way of making loans or advances or any other activity and the acquisition of shares, and is not any other category of NBFC as defined by the bank in any of its master circular. So a new definition of investment and credit company, this has also been provided in the separate NBFC acceptance of public deposits RBI directions of 2016. Now let's take a look at some of the MCQs which can be framed out of this topic. First question, non-banking financial company or NBFC is a company engaged in business of loans and advances, acquisition of shares, loans, bonds, debentures, securities, providing any service and sale, purchase, construction of immovable property, both A and B. So we have covered that NBFC can be in the business of loans or advances or in the business of acquiring the shares. So here our answer is going to be option number A and B, and that's why answer is going to be option number D. Which is not a correct difference between banks and NBFCs. NBFCs cannot accept demand deposits. NBFCs do not form part of the payment and settlement system and cannot issue checks drawn on itself. Deposit Insurance Facility of Deposit Insurance and Credit Guarantee Corporation is available to the depositors of NBFCs but not to banks or none of the above. So here we can see that the third difference is incorrect because this facility of deposit insurance is available to banks but not to NBFCs. Next question, which of the following NBFCs are exempted from RBI regulation? Options are housing finance companies, venture capital fund company or insurance company or all of the above. Now this is a very simple straightforward question. We have already learnt in order to obviate dual regulation, certain categories of NBFCs they are exempted from RBI regulation. So in those categories we have seen all these three types of NBFCs being mentioned. So here our answer is going to be option number D, all of the above. Next question, RBI has been given the power to register NBFCs that meet the dash criteria of the principal business. Options are 40-40, 50-50, 60-60 or none of the above. So this we have recently seen that this RBI has this power to register NBFC which meet this 50-50 criteria of principal business. So our answer is going to be option number B, 50-50 criteria. Now let's move on to the next question. NBFCs whose asset size is of dash as per the last audited balance sheet, they are considered as systemically important NBFCs. Options are 100 crore or more, 500 crore or more, 1000 crore or more, or none of the above. So this we have already covered how the NBFCs with asset size of more than 500 crores, they are categorized as systemically important NBFCs. So our answer is going to be option number B. Next question, RBI has recently decided to merge the three categories of NBFCs into a new category called NBFC Investment and Credit Company. Which of the following is not one of the three categories? Options are asset finance companies, loan companies, infrastructure finance companies or investment companies. So here we have seen that asset finance company, loan company and investment companies, they are all formed into one NBFC ICC category. So here our answer is going to be option number C, that is infrastructure finance company. So guys, these are the answers. So this was all about our discussion on one of the very recent RBI notification, and this one related to the concept of harmonization of the different categories of NBFCs. Thank you.